In this video, we will be discussing several behavior guidance techniques that may aid you in providing oral hygiene for individuals under your care. There are many reasons why providing oral hygiene for someone else can be difficult. Anxiety, resistance, low motivation for dental health, and difficulty listening to instructions are a few of them. With this video, we hope to provide you with a few techniques to make the process of taking care of someone's teeth an easier and more comfortable experience for everyone involved.
The first technique we will discuss will be tell, show, do. The tell, show, do method is a great way to help a person get interested in their own oral health and to learn directly from you. Tell, explain how to brush and floss and how these actions keep teeth clean and healthy. Make sure you use age-appropriate language and allow the individual to ask questions. You can make it fun by explaining that they are brushing and flossing to help get rid of sugar bugs. Show. If you have a model of teeth, you can demonstrate brushing and flossing on the model. Additionally, you can show the person on their fingers what you are about to do to their teeth. For instance, you can have them hold up multiple fingers and rub the toothbrush on the sides and use the floss to go between the fingers. Finally, if practical, you could have the individual watch you when you brush and floss your own teeth. Do. Help the person brush and floss their own teeth in the morning and before bed. Try to keep a regular routine so they know what's expected. The second technique is positive reinforcement. It is essential to give appropriate feedback in the process of establishing desirable behavior. Positive reinforcement rewards desired behaviors, thereby strengthening the likelihood of recurrence of those behaviors. Some examples include positive voice modulation, facial expression, verbal praise, and appropriate physical demonstrations of affection. Additionally, it is helpful to use descriptive praise that emphasizes specific cooperative behaviors such as, "Thank you for sitting still," and "You are doing a great job keeping your hands in your lap," rather than generalized praise such as, "Good job." Other reinforcers include tokens and toys. Another technique we can use is counting. Normally, when we think of counting as a behavior guidance tool, we think of people counting down during bad behavior that, if not stopped, will result in a consequence. However, we do not want oral hygiene to be associated with punishment. Instead, we suggest starting a slow countdown from 10 at the beginning of brushing and flossing. You decide for how long you wait in between numbers. Having the countdown may help calm the individual by providing them an idea of how much longer the brushing and flossing will last. The final technique we will discuss is distraction. Distraction is a technique of diverting an individual's attention from what they think is unpleasant. Distraction may be achieved by imagination, such as telling stories, and audio, such as music or visuals like television and movies. Similarly, giving the person a short break during a stressful procedure can be an effective use of distraction before considering more advanced behavior guidance techniques. Remember that different behavior guidance techniques will work with different people. For example, some may do well with distraction, while others may need all distractions removed. The goal is to get to know the individual and keep track of what works well to develop a successful mouth care routine. Remember, it is important to end every mouth care session positively. This means that you should stop brushing or flossing just before any negative behavior occurs. It is up to you to determine on a person-to-person basis the ability of a resident to care for their own teeth.
Thank you for watching this video. We hope that these suggested behavior guidance tools make providing oral hygiene comfortable for everyone involved.